Hi, today I'm going to talk to you about course navigation, which is all of these links on the left side inside a course. Let's start out by looking at student view. So if I look at the student view, I can see there's quite a few links here, not as many as when I was in teacher view, but still a lot for students to sort through. So what I'm going to show you today is how you can customize those links to just get the things your students need. So let's leave student view. And we're going to go down to the very bottom and we're going to go to settings. And we're going to go to the navigation tab, so the third tab over. And anything that's up here, students can see. Anything that's going to be below this drag item here to hide line, students won't see. So we want to drag everything that students don't need to see. So students need to see announcements, they need to see grades, they don't need to see pages, because if they can see the pages, they can go to other pages that aren't part of modules, and they can also go to parts of modules that you may have set restrictions for, like that they have to do something before they get to that page, but if they can see the pages, they'll be able to get there even outside the module. You wanna hide files, because they can see quiz keys in the files. You want to hide discussions and just add those discussions within the modules. If you don't use a notebook, you're going to want to hide that. You're going to want to hide outcomes. You're going to want to hide, keep the syllabus. That's good to keep. New analytics, that's just for you as the teacher, so just hide that. Conferences, we're not going to really be using that in Prince William County because it's so limited. You'll see that you have a Zoom option, and so that's what you'll want to keep. Studio, you might want to keep that, but if you're not going to view any collections in Studio, you just want to probably hide that. Assignments, again, you're going to add everything to modules, so you just want that to be hidden. We're going to probably move modules up to the top to make it, you know, the thing that you want students to see the most. People, now people you may want to keep up if you're going to be using group groupings where students can pick their groups. But if you're not going to be using students where or groups where students can pick their groups, which we'll show you in a later date, you might want to hide that. Collaborations, that would be useful to stay up. And Google Drive and Office, that will be good because you want them to connect their accounts. If you're not a Google school, you might want to hide Google. All right, so then when I'm done hiding everything, I'm just going to say save. And then when I go back to student view, and remember you can always get to student view here on the right-hand side, you'll see it's a much shorter list. It's, you know, putting the things that are most important near the top. It's gonna help your students. And your school may even come up with a order that they want these things in to make it common for students so that no matter what class they go to, they're gonna see the same links in the same order. Again, I'm gonna leave my student view or my student view. And I'm gonna go to settings because maybe you have a textbook or a website that you have your students go to often and you want it to appear over here in the navigation. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go in this course settings to apps and we're gonna look for an app called the redirect tool. The redirect tool looks like this and you wanna add that app. And for instance, maybe I wanna add a link to student view so I can easily, you know, let my students access their grades. I'm going to rename this student view. I'm going to put the link here and I'm going to say show it in course navigation because I want that to show up now in our course navigation. You're going to say add app and it was installed. So you will see if I refresh my page, I'm going to see that student view link. And again, if I want it to be higher up, I can just drag it up. You know, maybe student view is pretty important. Modules are pretty important. So I'll save. And then when I go back to student view, go to the student view, then you'll see that that student view link is now there and students can easily get to their student view account. So that's how you can modify the navigation. and how you can add a link. So what I want you to do today is go in your sandbox and modify your navigation to what you think makes sense for your students, as well as add any redirect links that you know your students are going to go to often. It's not a link for something like one-off. This is a link that you're going to have them go to repeatedly. All right, so have a great day.